So if you observe the first question, on Monday we will discuss on what is the sum of first 20 cubes. In a normal way, they will give you these questions, or in a theoretical format, they will give you 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube up to 20 cube. Either will be in the numbers notation or in a direct sentence format, but answer will be same. We know the formula sum of cubes. Formula is n into n plus 1 by 2 whole square. This will be the formula for sum of cubes of natural numbers. So just we have to apply on this formula. If you wanna apply, what it will be the result? N represents 20 because the last number. 20, n plus 1 become 21 divided by 2 with the whole square. So 2 ones are and 2 tens are will be cancelled. It become 2 tens 20. Then the product will be equal to 210. The product will be equal to 210. Then 210 whole square. Instead of calculating 210 square, directly calculate 21 square. 10 square become 100, we already know. So we multiply with 100. 21 square is nothing but 441. So lastly, we have to add two zeros. This will become the final answer. Just we have to apply formula n into n plus 1 by 2 whole square. Just if you substitute the values in this formula, then it will be done. Okay, now guys, let's move to the next one. The next question is 13 plus 26 plus 39 up to 650. Generally, we thought it is an arithmetic progression, but one more condition is there. If you consider 13 as common, then it will become 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 50. Because 13 ones are 13, 13 twos are 26, 13 threes are 39, up to 13 fives are 65, but they are giving 650, so we consider 50. 13 into 50 is become 650. Now our calculation will be simple. So 13 into, just apply n into n plus 1 by 2 formula because of sum of natural numbers. These all are become sum of natural numbers. Simply we will apply the formula. N into n plus 1 by 2. Here ending number is 50. 50 into 51 by 2. So 13 will be as it is. 50 into 51 by 2. If you cancel 2 ones, 2 25s. So 13 into 25 into 51. 25 into 51 is become 1275. So if you multiply 13 into 25, it will be 16575. This will be the final answer. 16575. And one more thing, they given options also for you. If you know options, then you can simply apply one more method. What are the options we have? 18352 option A. Option B 34525. Option C 16575. Option D 14323. If you observe, we are multiplying 13 into 50 into 51 by 2. So if you cancel, it become 13 into 25 into 51. So your answer is nothing but product of 13, 25 and 51. So your answer should be divisible by these three numbers. Now if you carefully observe, we don't know the 13 divisibility rule. It's very hard, no need to go with that. And normally if you considered, 25 is divisible by 5. So how many options are divisible by 5? Option A is not divisible because ending with 2. Option D is not divisible because ending with 3. Now we have two options, either B or C. Out of these two, our answer, we have to find out the answer. And 51. 51 is nothing but product of 17 and 13. 51 is nothing but 17 threes are 51. So answer should be divisible by 17 as well as 3. 3 divisibility rule we know. The sum of the numbers should be divisible by 3. Now if you add sum of the numbers, then only it will be divisible by 3. If you add 1, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 7, 14, 14 plus 5, 19, 19 plus 5, 24. So C is a possible answer. C may be divisible. But if you apply same rule for option B, 3 plus 4, 7 plus 2, 9. Okay, they are divisible. The remaining digits are 5 and 5. 5 and 5 become total 10. It is not divisible by 3. So our only option is C. No need to calculate the complete question. Then we'll move to the next one. Calculate the sum of this series 1000 plus 10 plus up to 64, 4, 27, 3, 8 to 2, 1, 1. If you observe from reverse order, they are nothing but 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 up to 10. So that is nothing but sum of natural numbers. And one more series also we have, that is 1 plus 8 plus 27 plus 64 up to 1000. This is nothing but sum of cubes from 1 to 10. This is the first series is nothing but sum of natural numbers from 1 to 10. We have to calculate these two. That's it. Sum of natural numbers from 1 to 10. Sum of cubes of natural numbers from 1 to 10. Now, sum of natural numbers 1 to 10. If you calculate, the formula will be n into n plus 1 by 2. That is become 10 into 11 by 2. And if you calculate sum of cubes from 1 to 10, n into n plus 1 by 2 whole square. Both are looking like same with the calculation. If you try to calculate 2 ones, 2 fives are, so it will become 55. Here also same, 2 ones, 2 fives, it become 55 square. So our final calculation is, one is 55, another one is 55 square. 55 plus 55 square. 55 square is nothing but 3025. Just we have to add 55 to these numbers. It becomes 3075. So your answer is 3075. Sorry, 3080. 3080. 5 plus 5, 10. 3080. Now, moving to the next question. Babu has 290 rupees in a combination of coins, 2 rupees and 5 rupees, and total number of coins are 100. They given total number of coins 100. Total amount is nothing but 290. So what I will do? I assume all the coins are 2 rupees only. So if all the coins, 100 coins are 2 rupees, then our value should be 200. But how much we have extra? 90 rupees we have extra, because 200 minus 290. This 90 rupees extra, why? Because 5 rupees coins. Now if I wanna calculate 5 rupees coins, this extra amount is 90. Extra amount, how much we considered for each coin? Actually 5 rupees coins are there, but we consider as 2 rupees. The difference between 5 and 2 is 3 rupees. I have to divide with this 3. 90 divided by 3, it become 30. So extra coins are 30. Extra coins is nothing but 5 rupees coins. If all considered as 2 rupees coins, it will become total amount as 200. But we have 90 rupees extra. This extra because of 5 rupees coins. The difference between 2 and 5 is 3 rupees. That's why we are dividing with 3. Then we got the answer 30. That is nothing but 5 rupees coins are 30 coins. Simple. Then we'll move to the next one. Kumar earns 300 rupees on first day, spends 200 on second day, earns 300 on third day, and spends 200 on fourth day, and so on. After how many days he had 2000 rupees? So the rule is common. First day he will earn the money, second day he will spend. But savings are 100 rupees. Savings are 100 rupees for 2 days. Generally people will calculate ₹100 for 2 days, ₹2,000 for 40 days. But that is not the exact answer, because they are not asking to save ₹2,000 after how many days he had ₹2,000. So on the final one day, he will get ₹300. So subtract that ₹300 from the total amount. If you subtract 300 from 2000, your answer will be 1700. So if he saves 1700, on the next day he will get a 300, the total become 2000. So ₹1700. Then our calculation will be same. ₹100 for 2 days. 1700 for how many days? 00, 00 get cancelled. 00, 00 get cancelled. 17 twos are directly 34 days. 34 days he will save ₹1700. On 35th day he will get ₹300 as income. On 35th day he will get ₹300 as income. Total become 2000. So the final number of days are 35 days. Then we will move to the next one. This is a question asked by a student as a doubt. In probability, we have to discuss one of the important model and asked by a student. That's why I given for the Saturday purpose. Here, the word prison should be arranged in dictionary order. The first letter in dictionary order will be I. So except I, we have how many letters? 5 letters. Total number of letters are 6. Except I, we have 5 letters. 5 factorial ways we can write the numbers. That is nothing but 120. Next, second letter is N. This is also not ours. We have to solve up to P. This is also remaining 5 factorial ways, 120 ways. Next, alphabetical order is O. This is also same 5 factorial. That is nothing but 120. Next coming is P. This is our answer. So don't go beyond, because our word prison first letter is P. After P, the alphabetical order is PI. Now, 2 letters are over. The remaining letters are 4. So we have to write 4 factorial ways. That is nothing but 24. After PI, we have PO. That is also 4 factorial ways, 24. 24 ways. Next, after PO, we have PR. After I, and N is also there. Wait a second. We have to write N also. After PI, PN. This is also same 4 factorial ways, 24. After PN, we have to write PO. Next alphabetical order after N is O. This is 4 factorial, 24. Next is PR, but we required PR also. That's why we consider PR. Next, we go for the next alphabet. After PR, I is the alphabet order remaining in the operation word. So I also we required, because our spring is PRISON. After I, the remaining alphabetical order is N. So PRIN, 4 letters we calculated, we already done. So the remaining is 2 factorial, that is nothing but 2. After PRIN, we have PRIO. Because after N, O, this is also 2 factorial, remaining 2 letters. The answer is 2 ways. After PRIO, we have to write PRIS. This is also we required. Then go for the next letter. In N and O, first alphabetical preference is N. So remaining one letter, we have to write one ways. After that, PRISO, then we have to write N also. Because after O, there is no remaining letters, we have to write N. This is also one way. Now what we have to do is, add all the numbers to find the rank. 120 plus 120 plus 120, these become 360. These become 360. 24 plus 24 plus 24. 24 threes are. These become 72. And 2 plus 2 plus 1. these become 5, and this is one more letter, last word, pressure. Now add these numbers, that will be simple. 360 plus 72, 360 plus 72 plus 5 plus 1, this total become 438. If you add all the numbers, the total become 438. So the rank of the word precision is 438, one of the important model in probability, but a student asked it out, so we will discuss now. Any question, if you find the anchor order ranking, if you are follow an alphabetical order, you will get the answer. First alphabet, second alphabet, third alphabet according to the given words, that is more than enough. So finally, if you add, the answer will be 438. Okay guys, thank you.